In this video, we will be going through a brief overview of the history of the computer. So, before we can really look back into history and identify computers throughout history, we really need to answer the question, what exactly is a computer? What is the bare bones definition of a computer? So, go ahead and take a moment, pause the video, and think to yourself, what exactly is a computer? What is your definition of a computer? When you think of a computer, what sort of things come to mind? So take a moment, think about that, and then continue the rest of the video. Great. So for me, when I think of a computer, this is generally what I think of. I think of these modern sleek devices that have all these fancy buttons and cool colors and can do these really awesome things. But what is it about these different devices that makes them a computer? What exactly is it about the things that make them computers? Well, really at the core of it's a computer is just a computing machine that can perform calculations according to precise instructions. Computers are things that take an instructions and then perform mathematical and logical operations. So that's really all they are. They are calculators with a lot of added benefits on top. And really the only thing that separates a computer from a human is that it can do these operations incredibly fast. It's doing very simple mathematical operations. A second grader could do the mathematical operations that computers do. The only difference is that a computer can do it at lightning speeds, or speed millions, billions of times per second. In fact, the first definition of a computer was used to refer a person in 1913. The word computer was first used to describe a person who performed calculations or computations. So, the first computers were people. It's only recently that we've taken this term and applied to these computing machines that are actually rapidly carrying out these mathematical calculations. So, with this definition of computers, let's look back in history and see where exactly computers came from. Let's look at the timeline of computer development. So, the very first computer, the very first computing machine was actually found in 26,000 BC. It was the Chinese abacus, and the abacus was simply a little device to use to help you carry out mathematical operations, and that was pretty much it. That was the standard for computers for the next fourth in years until we get to 1910, and in 1910, Henry Babbage constructed part of Charles Babbage's analytical engine. This is actually a mechanical machine that you hand cracked, and then while cranking, it would flip all the switches and actually perform basic mathematical calculations like addition and subtraction. Now that was a 4,000 year difference. Let's jump ahead just 40 years now. We see that 1930 Konrad Zuse actually made the Z1, which was the first binary digital computer. So this computer actually used electricity instead of hand cracking with gears, and it used binary as the number system that it did calculations in. So it only uses zeros and ones in the numbers that it represents, and we will get into more about how this works later. But the binary number system only uses zeros and ones, and this really simplifies things. It makes it so you only have to represent two different digits, zero and one. So this was the first binary digital computer, and that same year in 1936, Alan Turing actually came up with the Turing machine theory, and this was actually a huge step forward for theoretical computing. Alan Turing theorized, didn't actually build this machine. He just came with this idea of a machine that pretty much could read and write symbols on a strip of paper, so it could remember what it had previously seen by going back and looking at the strip of paper, and it could write out new symbols on the blank parts of the piece of paper. And in doing this, in coming up with this theoretical machine, mathematicians were actually able to answer a lot of computing, what exactly can be computed by a computing machine, and what cannot be computed by a computing machine. So this was the foundation of theoretical computing machine. Fast forward 10 years in 1946, we have the ENIAC, which is the first electronic general purpose computer. So this computer, instead of being pre-programmed to the only compute one specific calculation, it could be reprogrammed to compute whatever calculation you wanted. And this was huge, and this is used for the military to compute different trajectories for missiles. And the people who programmed the ENIAC were all women. Women were the first computer programmers programming the ENIAC in 1950. We had UNIAC, which was the first modern computer. So instead of having all these switches that you would have to turn on and off the program, actually you had a keyboard for input, and it had disk memory as well, so it could remember the computations that had calculator. However, the UNIAC still took up an entire room. It was this massive computer, only used in business and government. In 1975 is when we had the first actual portable computer that wasn't stuck in a room. However, it still weighed 55 pounds, and it had only a tiny 5-inch display screen, and it only had 64 kilobytes of memory. That's less than one song of memory. Now, that was 1975. It took 4,000 years to get from the first abacus to Charles Babbage's analytical engine, and the last 50 years since the portable computer from IBM, we've seen an incredible advancement in computers. We now have iPhones, personal computers, and tablets, and watches, and computers are in everything that we use today. We've seen such a fast rate of change with computers in terms of their size and how quickly they can carry out operations and what they are being used in. There's actually a law called Moore's Law that applies to this exact concept. So Moore's Law states that the processing speed of computer, the rate at which can carry out operations, should double every 2 years as we get better and better at making these processors. And so far, the actual rate of increase has held pretty close to the theoretical rate. It has almost doubled every 2 years. This is an exponential rate of increase. We are getting computers that are smaller and smaller and smaller and faster and faster and faster in 50 years. Who knows what computers will be able to solve? That's a brief timeline of the history of computers. Now, why exactly are people making these computers? Why did they need them? Why don't we just carry out these mathematical calculations by hand? Well, the first uses of computers were really for a couple things. People wanted to keep counts of things like livestock. They were used in marketplace for things like summing money, so there's no error there. You are having a computer do it. And they were also used to calculate astronomical positions, so if we could predict where the stars would be headed, this is really helpful for things like navigation and calendars. When people started realizing how useful these computers could be, we started really getting behind the development of computers and really putting a lot of effort into making computers faster and smaller. So the users that were really driving development were to solve math problems faster and solve more complex types of math problems. There were decoding encrypted messages during wars, or computing the proper trajectory of missiles. And there's several business uses as well. We wanted to automate the production of goods, and we wanted to keep track of financial data and consumer data and all sorts of data. So these are great uses for computers that we are driving the development of computers. So now let's take a look at modern computers. We've seen a timeline of history of computers, but what do computers look like today, and what are we using them for today? Well, you are probably familiar with these modern computers, laptops and desktops and tablets, and these are computers, but these are also computers, phones and smartwatches and toys and cars and simple appliances are really computers are pervading our modern life. And they are being put in everything to make them smarter, make them faster, and make them better. Really, on the difference between these computers and these computers is the programming. And what I mean by programming. So a program is a set of instructions written by a human that is giving to a computer to tell it what to do with these computers. And these are very general purpose. We can write programs on these computers, so to have them solve all sorts of problems, whereas these computers come prepackaged with a specific program that make them do one simple thing. For example, the coffee maker comes prepackaged with the program that tells it what to do when a user presses a certain button to the robot. The robot pet dog might come with a predefined program that tells it how to react to touch or how to react to live things. So these are all computers. So what are we using these computers for? Well, the answer to that is almost everything, but let's look at a few applications of computers in today's world. So we're using computers for things like autopilot. We are making planes and cars drive themselves. They are used in several medical devices like the defibrillators and pacemakers. They are being used in art to create digital art and share art between artists. And they are being used to create music, to visualize music, to perform music. And they are being used in agriculture to monitor the production of crops and predict future yields. And they are being used in health and medicine to improve the quality of life for many medical patients. It's being used in health and medicine as well to monitor the outbreak of disease and try to prevent huge epidemics. And of course, computers are being used to connect us. There is social media through messages, through news on the internet. We are more connected today than ever have been, and that's all thanks to computers. So this is a brief overview of the history of computers. We've come an incredibly long way, all the way from those first very primitive computing machines to the computers today that are connecting us and helping us solve our toughest problems.